is a video that shows how I've gone about trying to balance my hyperbike. Just to start off the video, these are the B shafts, the B length shafts for the B size pony. They go, the tallest mini that they'll fit is a 37 inch mini. Sky's 37 inches, and I call her mature because she's kind of chubby. So I don't think these shafts are fitting her very well. I think they're a little bit too small. And so to start off, I'll say that I emailed Bob and he's sending me a set of the C shafts to try, which I'm hoping those will work because my other two ponies are 40 inches and 41 and a half, and that's the size I'll need for them anyway. So I'm hoping that those are the answer to my problems. But anyway, I just wanted, as a learning thing for everybody and myself, to go through each thing that we've tried to try to get it to balance really nicely. So right now it's set up as it came in the box. The seat's all the way back. The wheels are on the second hole in the middle one. My breeching is pretty loose, as you can see, and my shaft loops are down where they would be for my easy entry shafts. So this is how the very first time I had it set up, and the stirrups are short. This is shorter than what I usually have been having them on. So I'll get in and you can see what happens.
Yes.
Graceful getting in. As you can see, if I lean back, the shafts are already popping up to the top of my shaft loops. I cannot lean back in the seat. I feel like it's going to flip over. I know I'm not heavier than her, but it's just very stomach flipping when this happens. So this is not working, and this is not how we're going to drive her. So now we're going to make some adjustments and see if we can change the balance a little bit. So I'm going to get off and try again. Alright, so the first thing I would have tried, and I did try, is to push the seat up to put some weight into the shaft ends. So I'll show you what that looks like. The only adjustment I did. Stand still. I know, Mom, you're being good. So with the seat up, the stirrup short, I can sort of lean back, but if I lean back like I want to, there they pop all the way up, and now they're really pushing up in those shaft loops, which she doesn't really love. So that the seat is as far forward as it can go right now. So now I'll get off and I'm gonna adjust my shaft loops and raise my wheels. Raising the wheels will raise my center of gravity, which should push weight down onto the shaft loops, because if I could be up here, then the shaft ends would be down low. So now we'll try that. Stand still, Sky. Oh, good. Okay, now I'm gonna raise the wheels to the tallest setting. So when this is popped out and the inner side of this is pushed in, then that means the wheels are locked into place. We raise the wheels to the highest setting, so I'll jump on now. So the changes we've made, move the seat forward, raise the wheels. We haven't done anything with the harness at this point or with the stirrups, so let me try it now. Can't lean back because it makes my shafts pop up. So now we're going to try. I'm going to move my stirrups up and raise my shaft loops. I know that sounds strange, but I think it's going to help hold the end of those shafts down. And I'm going to tighten up my breeching a little bit to try to hold her in the shafts in the spot that I need her to be. So I want her to be as far forward as I can get her, because hopefully that will help those shafts stay when I sit back in it like you're supposed to be able to. So let's give that a try. Thank you. Okay, so I also lengthened my trace one hole to try to push this shaft loop as far forward into the shaft as I can. The shafts are sure rubbing on the buckle, but anyway, to try to get this curve to be back at the saddle. That's where this curve should be anyway. It shouldn't ever be on the breast collar. So that gives me a little bit more room actually between her butt and the seat. And then I also moved my stirrups forward on the other side. And I have a bad knee, so I found when I drive it with the short stirrups, it just kills my knees. So I do need them a little long. I'm not sure if this is exactly where I had them before. I'll have to get on and see, but that will be the test. I raised this one hole and then I tightened up the bridging, but you can see there's still room. I know people were worried that she couldn't move because it's as tight as it goes, but this bridging also fits my 40-inch pony. I got a little bigger bridging, so it's plenty. There's plenty of room there. My whole hand fits in there. So I will get on this way and we'll see how the balance is now. Alright, that's a little better. Still though, the ends of my shafts are pressing up into the tops of that shaft loop. If I sit forward, then I'm good, but I don't think that's the point, because the times that I've been driving it sitting forward like that, I just get really tired. And I can't, it's not relaxing. I can't ever lean back really. If I go over any bumps or down in the ditches or anything, the cart flips upward. And I just really don't think that's how it's supposed to ride. I know when I had one many years ago with my other pony, it never did that. It rode level with a little bit of weight in the ends of the shafts. When I was on level ground, those shafts just kind of floated in those loops and they never bounced. This is what I consider bouncing. So when I go over bumps, you can see what that would do. And clearly she doesn't like it. And when we've done it, trotting out there, she gets pretty ticked off when that happens, and she'll toss her head and give a little bounce. I don't blame her. So what we want is there a little bit of weight in those shafts, in those ends of those shafts, or to just have a little float where it just does this when she's going. Can you see, can you zoom in on that? This is called float, when the shafts just kind of float in those loops. Oops, sorry, not that high. When they just kind of float like this, this is called bounce. You do not want bounce. You want float or a little bit of weight. 5 pounds or less is ideal. A little bit more than five is okay if you're on level ground. I wouldn't go as high as 10 ever on their back. That's my preference, that's my opinion, blah, blah, blah. So, you know, I guess if you have more than that and your pony's fine with it, that's fine. I would pay attention to if your pony starts to get sore or upset, because then you'll know kind of maybe what's causing that if your cart isn't very well balanced. So that's about all I can do on this one for adjustments. It's forward as far as it can go. I definitely can't put the seat back, because then, as you can see, I'll really flip those shaft ends up if I move my seat back. There is a little bit of room today. I think maybe in the pictures it looks like there's less room than there is in real life. Walk up. Maybe you can see, I don't know. Really hard to do this video actually. Maybe you can see how much room there is. There's a good hand's width there. So maybe that helps some people who thought that she was far too close to the seat. I do think that the shafts aren't long enough, because I can't get her forward further and she needs to be forward. And also her sides rub the shafts the whole time. So can you come and show, like, from up above or maybe from the back? As you can see, her stomach is touching. I can't get my fingers in there. When I do up the britching, it's real tight to get that strap down in there. See that? I don't think, it wasn't like that on my other horse, and I think that they're not supposed to be that tight. I know she's chubby, but she's always big. Even when she's slim, she would be too big for this, I think, because most of her chubbiness is hangy belly, like a mama belly, more so than being too wide. She's already just a wide mini. So and my other two are built like her. They're pretty wide in the back, and so I just think the C shafts are going to be the way to go. So hopefully this video gave some people some things to think about. And these are just your basic 11-foot reins. So you can see how much too long they are. So what I did was I sat in the cart and I held them where I want them, which I really don't want them much longer than this right here. So I can adjust like this, but I'm never going to need them this long to be back here by my neck, you know. I'm just not going to need that for my personal preference. And I would like to not have a bunch of loop hanging down or having to sit on any rein. So I did order a 6.5-foot purple rein. So we'll see how that looks when I get it, but I think that's going to be perfect. I just measured from her bit to my hands and gave myself another couple inches, and it was 6.5 feet. So trying to think. I think that's all the questions or comments that people had. If you can think of any more or any more ideas on to how to make this work better, then I would love to hear them. I will comment, though, that moving the stirrups forward did help me put more weight at the end of my shaft where I needed it. Having them back not only hurt my knees, but also I had a hard time putting enough weight in my stirrups to help keep that shaft down. So maybe if you're having trouble, move your stirrups forward a little. I don't know. That seemed to really help. So here I am trying to sit like I should, and it's not working. So anyway, I will also do another video when I get the C shafts, and we'll see how that goes. So thanks for watching.